Okay, so now we have three norms that we claim are going to be important in this class. The two norm, the one norm, and the infinity norm. And here I'm looking only at vectors with two components, so we're going to look at two-dimensional space. And if you look carefully for the rest, you also notice that I left the absolute value off of the components for the two norm. And that's because I'm only going to be looking at real valued vectors. Okay, so all of our vectors are going to be in R2. Now, this particular property of norms is going to play a very important role. And what it really says is that in a lot of cases, we care more about the direction of the vector than we do about its length, and therefore it is important to pick a vector of convenient length. And what length is more convenient than length 1? So it's important to be able to visualize what the set of all vectors with 2 norm equal to 1 looks like, or 1 norm equal to 1, or infinity norm equal to 1. So to do that, we're going to look at vectors with two components, real valued only. And if we remember that we can visualize vectors in two-dimensional space by rooting the vector at the origin and then looking at the point to which the vector points, then we can say, oh, the set of all vectors with 2 norm equal to 1 maps out a certain set of points in our two-dimensional space, and that allows us to visualize this set of all vectors with 2 norm equal to 1. That set, by the way, is often called the unit ball. Of course, in 2 space, it's the unit circle. In 3 space, it would be the unit ball. Beyond that, hard to visualize. So go and do the homework, and then we'll discuss the results of that homework in the next video.